Is it okay? You got to.
Feel as if I need to sing a song. Greg, just maybe so we can get, could we have the back screen on as well? Or maybe there's just nothing on at the moment. I think it is on. Right, we're going to light our fourth Advent candle. I think Sheila has organized for someone to come up and do that. Great. It's the fourth one we're doing, so we're getting near Christmas, which of course is next week. So we'll light our fourth candle, which traditionally refers to peace. There you go, there's that we do for there. Brilliant. Thank you very much indeed. Round of applause for our candle lighters. So we've got a prayer now on the screen, if we can all pray this together about peace. Say these words together. Lord Jesus, come close to us this Advent and fill our hearts with peace. We pray today for everyone who lives in the middle of conflict or war, and for those who long for peace in body, mind, or soul. May we all know your peace, a peace that passes all understanding. Amen. In the Message version of the Bible, we read this about the shepherds. As the angel choir withdrew into heaven, the shepherds talked it over. Let's go over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us. And like the shepherds, we come with anticipation to celebrate what God did that first Christmas by sending Jesus. So we're going to sing now together. Come and join the celebration. To sing.
Let us pray. A bright star shining, angels singing, wise men worshipping, shepherds hurrying, a mother treasuring, a baby lying in a manger. Lord God, our Father, thank you for that baby who did not lie in a fancy cot in a palace, but a feeding box in a stable. Thanks for that baby who was your son. God came as one of us. What amazing love you have for us, that you send your son Jesus into this world. We praise you for his incredible birth at Bethlehem, his perfect life, his death for us on the cross of Calvary, and his rising again from the grave, and that he is coming back again one day. As we come together this morning, open our hearts to see the wonder of the first Christmas and what it means for us here and now. We bring this prayer in Jesus' name and continue in the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Kate Baxter will now read as part of the Christmas story from the Bible.
Our reading this morning is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Greg. Thank you, Kate. Philip on the for us. Can you hear me? Yes? That's good. Just a short prayer. Andy, I'm going to hold it. I'll just hold it. Perfectly fine. Take that. Lord, we ask your blessing on this service this morning. We thank you that Jesus is Lord, and we ask that we will all be able to focus on him and know who he is, and worship him, and respond to him in love and faith. So put your hedge of protection round about us now, Lord, and continue with us. May we know your peace and your presence. Glory to you, we ask, in Jesus' name. Amen. So we come now to our nativity. We don't have any small human performers to help us with this year, but we do have some cartoon characters by way of video. So we'll have four video segments for the Christmas story, and they'll be interspersed with carols, which will begin unannounced. So remain seated and join in with the carols that will come up on the screen as we go through. So let us begin our nativity.
The story of Christmas, Mary and Joseph. This is Mary.
Hi!
You see, Mary was the mother of Jesus, but before that happened, she lived in the town of Nazareth. Mary had no children because she lived according to God's law and had never been married. But she was engaged to marry a man named Joseph.
Heyo.
Hi, Joseph.
One day, an angel came to Mary and said,
Hi.
That God had chosen Mary. The angel said, God is with you. But Mary was afraid and confused.
Huh?
She wondered what the angel was talking about. Then the angel said, Don't be afraid. God loves you and wants to use you in a great way.
Me?
You will give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be very great, and he will be the king forever.
Hold on.
Mary asked, But how can this happen? for she was not married yet and knew that she couldn't have a child until she was married. But the angel told Mary that the Holy Spirit would make her pregnant.
Wow!
So that the baby born will be holy and will be called the Son of God.
Wow!
The angel reminded her that nothing is impossible with God. So Mary decided to trust God and all that He had planned for her. Before their wedding, Joseph found out that Mary was pregnant.
Wait, what?
He thought she had done something wrong. But Joseph was a man of God and decided to break off the engagement quietly so no one around town would think badly of Mary. While Joseph was thinking about all this, an angel appeared to him in a dream.
Hello.
Hi?
The angel said, Joseph, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife.
What?
The angel explained that Mary's baby was from God.
Wait, what?
The angel told Joseph that the baby's name would be Jesus, and he would save his people from their sins.
Oh, wow.
And when Joseph woke up, he did as the angel told him.
Hi.
You ready?
Really? Yeah!
And took Mary as his wife while she was still pregnant with a son of God. And so Joseph and Mary trusted in God, and the two followed the plan that God had given them to help bring the Savior into the world. Story of Christmas. Jesus is born. Not long after that, the ruler of the land, Caesar Augustus, wanted to count how many people were in the land. So Caesar Augustus ordered everyone in the land to travel back to their hometowns so that they could be counted. Joseph's hometown was Bethlehem, so Mary and Joseph traveled from Nazareth all the way to Bethlehem. When they arrived in Bethlehem, they looked for a place to stay.
No, I'm sorry.
Oh, man.
but there was no room for them.
What about there?
Okay.
So they stayed in a barn, and while they were there, Mary gave birth to Jesus.
Whoa.
She wrapped him snugly in the strips of cloth.
That'll work.
And laid him in a manger.
Excuse me.
And so the Son of God, the Savior of the world, was born in a barn in Bethlehem. Of Christmas, Jesus and the Shepherds. On the night Jesus was born, there were some shepherds in the field keeping watch over their sheep. Suddenly, an angel appeared before them. And a bright light shone all around them. The shepherds were so scared, but the angel said, "Don't be afraid.
Okay.
I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David."
Whoa, what?
The angel told the shepherds that they would find Jesus in a barn wrapped in strips of cloth, laying in a manger.
Okay.
Then the angel was joined by many, many other angels, and all of them sang, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." Then the angels returned to heaven.
What just happened?
And the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem."
Yeah.
So they hurried to the village.
You say that.
And found the baby Jesus laying in the manger.
Wow!
After seeing Jesus, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had told them about the baby Jesus. Everyone who heard the shepherd's story were amazed. Mary made sure she remembered all these things and thought about them often. Then the shepherds went back to their sheep and praised God for all they had seen. The baby was exactly who the angel had told them he was, the Savior of the world, the Son of God. The story of Christmas, Jesus and the wise men. Bethlehem was part of Judea, an area that was ruled by a king named Herod. King Herod was in Jerusalem when some wise men from eastern lands arrived in Jerusalem asking,
"Excuse me,
where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star as it rose, and we have come to worship him." When Herod heard that there was another king born in Judea, he was very upset, as was everyone else in Jerusalem.
Yeah, not you.
So Herod called all the important priests and Jews together and asked them where this king was supposed to be born. The Jews knew that their king would eventually come, and it was always told to them that the king of the Jews, the savior of the world, would be born in Bethlehem. So they told that to King Herod. Then King Herod thought of a way to trick the wise men. So he called a private meeting with them and learned from them when the king of the Jews' star first appeared.
Oh, good!
And then King Herod told the wise men, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. And when you find him, come back and tell me so that I can go and worship him too."
Okay. Hey, on your way.
But secretly, Herod wanted to know where the king of the Jews was so he could get rid of him. So the wise men went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where Jesus was, and the wise men were filled with joy.
Woohoo!
They went into the house and saw Mary and Jesus.
Hello!
Oh, look! Wow!
And they bowed down and worshiped Jesus.
Wait!
They gave him special gifts fit for the king that he was, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then God warned them in a dream to not go home through Jerusalem, where King Herod was, but God told them to go home a different way. So they did. And then an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up." The angel told Joseph to go to Egypt with Mary and Jesus because Herod was looking to kill Jesus. That very night, Joseph left for Egypt with Jesus and Mary. They stayed in Egypt until Herod was gone, and it was safe for them to go home to Israel. When they returned, an angel warned them about the new ruler of Judea, who was Herod's son.
This way.
So Joseph and his family went to the region of Galilee and found their new home in the town of Nazareth.
Look good?
Yep.
We'll take it.
Where Jesus would grow up and eventually do all the amazing things God had planned for him to do.
Thank you.
Wasn't that an excellent series of videos? Really very good. And I like how it took the story through past the wise men coming to the family, going down into Egypt and then back to Nazareth. I wonder who your favourite character is in the Christmas story. If you were going to have come dressed as one today, who would you have come dressed as? Shepherds. Like the shepherds. Wise men. The shepherds, of course, just ordinary working folk getting on with their work in the fields there with the sheep. And what an unusual, unexpected thing happened as the angel appeared. I like the angels in the cartoon as well. They're not quite what we would normally paint or draw a shepherd as. So they were excellent. But these shepherds, they heard that news, and what did they do? They believed it. They said yes to God's message, and they went and found the baby just as it had been told them. And of course, the fact that it was in a manger, an animal's feeding trough, told them it was the right baby. It wasn't just any old baby. It was the baby that had come. And the wise men, of course, intelligent, thinking people, searching things out, and they had worked out in whatever way it was through the looking at the skies and so on. They worked out that a very special king had arrived and that he was God. Quite a thing that they understood. And when they came, did you notice them bowing down and worshipping the baby? That's what they did. That's what we're told they did. Jesus, you see, is God. He was only a wee baby. God come to be one of us. And of course, Mary, this young girl, her life was totally changed by this news that she, unmarried at this point, was going to be the mother of Jesus. This hugely important baby. And what did she say? I liked it in the cartoon. I like the wee noises they make. Okay. Yes, she said, yes. Let it be to me as you have said, she said to God. And she became that mother. And Joseph, of course, we can forget about Joseph. There in the outfitters getting dressed for his wedding and then prepared to call it all off. But he took tremendous trust on his part, trust in Mary and trust in God that it was going to be okay because this baby had been brought about by God himself, the Holy Spirit, in Mary, and going ahead and saying yes to God. There was one wee phrase, I don't know whether you noticed, that was used to describe Jesus quite a number of times in these videos. Did you hear it? It was this, the Savior of the world. He's the Savior of the world. When we respond to Jesus, when we trust in him, that's what he does. He saves us from all that otherwise would have happened. He forgives us. He gives us meaning and purpose in life. How we need that. This is not a random universe. God made it for a purpose, and in Jesus we find that reason. He also brings peace in our hearts. Are you afraid this morning? There's so much fear about, isn't there? Jesus comes to calm that fear, to bring peace. He comes to give us eternal life, now and forever with him. What a wonderful message this is to rejoice in this morning. It is joy to the world. These wise men that came from so far away at such cost to themselves, they're a picture of the whole world coming to Jesus. People seek him and find him all over the world. The church is growing in other parts of the world, though, even though it seems to be declining here. May God turn that about, but the church is growing in other parts of the world. So what is the the call for us to do. What did all these characters do in one way or another, in all their different ways? They said yes to Jesus. May we be able to say yes to Jesus in the depths of our hearts today. Let us pray. Lord God, our Father, we have travelled with the shepherds, obeying the angel's message, and we've travelled with the wise men, following the star. They came to where your son was, and they worshipped him. They couldn't stop telling others about him. They opened their hearts to him. They opened their treasures to him. They went back into their lives, totally changed by meeting Jesus. We worship him too, Lord, this morning. And may we also bring the offering of ourselves in glad thanksgiving for your amazing gift of Jesus Christ, your Son, the Savior of the world. Father, we ask that the gifts we give today for Edinburgh City Mission will be used in your hands to enable them to serve people who are homeless, hungry, and in great need in many different ways, so that they are helped very much and sense your love for them. We also pray for all those in our own town who are poor and hungry, whose lives are chaotic, whose relationships are broken, who are in much need. May they find too in Jesus and in the help you give through your people. May they find your love for them. We remember how Jesus was born in a manger because there was no room for him anywhere else. He knows what it is to be poor and dependent. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for the wonder of this season. In and through the excitement of it all, of presents to open and enjoy, of family gatherings and all our celebrations, may we not forget who it is all about. May we remember the child who lay in the manger, who grew to be a man, who was God come as one of us, came to save us by dying on the cross and rising again in power. May we open our hearts to him, Lord. We pray for your people all around the world at this Christmas time. When sometimes those who oppose the Christian faith do bad things to your people, because it is Christmas, please protect your people from that everywhere. May we all be able to worship Jesus and tell others about him freely and safely. Lord, we know there are many people who are sad and sick and suffering and lonely and all kinds of need this Christmas, just as at other times of the year. We pray for them. May they know and experience the true message of Christmas, that Jesus came into this world to share everything we go through, to sit down beside us and help us, to be our Savior by dying on the cross, to take away our sin, and to bring true comfort, help, and new life, hope, and joy forever. Thank you, Lord. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So it's been great to have you all here this morning. Blessings to you this Christmas time. Our closing carol is a very well-known one, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. We'll stand to sing. go now to rejoice in our Lord Jesus Christ. And let's say the grace to one another. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore.
Whoever he chooses to hear his voice. He came to Nazareth, the town in which he had been raised. On the Sabbath, he went to the synagogue. He read from the prophecy of Isaiah and then preached. The congregation were so infuriated that they physically ran him out of town, hoping to throw him over the brow of a nearby hill.
Firstborn of Mary, provocative preacher, itinerant teacher, outsider's choice. Jesus inspires and disarms and confuses whoever he chooses to hear his voice.
He went into the house of a man called Levi.